well-deserved massage for the best Nordic combined athlete at the Winter Universiade in Slovakia. Adam Ciesler won the two individual titles at Strzepska Plesa, but the Polish student had to fight hard for it. So what finally was the key to victory? I managed to stay calm at the beginning of the event to demonstrate my mental strength. I think that was the reason I was able to win.
Trzeba robić na tyle, ile się w danym momencie wie, ile można, żeby nie przedobrzyć.
So Ciesler now adds these medals to another two golds and the silver he won at the Universiade 2 years ago in Trentino. And now the reward after the rigors of competition.
Jestem bardzo zadowolony.
I couldn't feel better. I simply did my job and got the medals. But before coming to the Universiade, Adam doubted his ability. He hadn't even been sure about continuing his career. Now he was lying third after the ski jump, and in the 10-kilometer cross-country race, he battled with David Velder of Germany for the victory. It was an extraordinary finish. Ciesler making it home by a margin of 2 centimeters over Velder.
I'm
so surprised at what I've done, surprised that I could find the necessary energy for those final meters. Well, the defending champion may have been surprised, but his coach wasn't. He had faith in Adam's qualities.
I think mentality and also this his character, because Nordic combiner have to have really strong character to fight on cross-country race, and also when he's coming down from gate, he must keep this pressure, and Adam is for me like completed in these two sides, and this is also his secret, that he is fighter.
Ciesler felt his shape was back. The second event began with the cross-country, a 10-kilometer mass start. Ciesler finishing behind Velder and Samir Mastiev of Russia. But the silver medalist from Trentino would push for the victory on the ski jump. Technical problems on the hill delayed the start of that competition. Adam knowing that if he wanted a good performance, his skis had to be perfectly prepared and he'd have to stay absolutely focused. But the physical education student from the University of Warsaw did what he had to do. A score of 216.9 and Ciesler taking the victory ahead of Velder and his Polish teammate, Matthias Wantulak. The Universiade was a decisive episode in his career. These university games have given me a lot of confidence. And they've also shown me you have to be patient if you want to be victorious. The event really gave me so much. Now the holder of 4 Universiade titles, Adam Ciesler is no longer lacking the motivation to continue his career. And who knows what new heights he may reach in competitions to come. In terms of multidisciplinary tournaments, the Universiade is the world's number 2 after the Olympics. And in ice hockey, for the players of the 11 teams who gathered at Granada in Spain, these university games provided a great stage for their talents.
I think it's really important tournament for everybody in there because we are students and this is the part of our career and we can make maybe some steps in the future.
For many of these students, ice hockey is a priority for the future, especially in the major hockey nations like Russia, United States, and Canada.
At every level in our country, it's the number one sport. Our kids grow up playing hockey, and then they all hope to play for Canada's team at one time, or the NHL.
Under the gaze of the Swedish team, in the final of the Universiade, Russia would beat Kazakhstan by 3-1. But it wasn't so much the score the Swedes were interested in as the strength and style of the players.
Well, if you look at the, how we train, how we live, we're part-time hockey players, mostly students. There is a big, big difference if you look at player by player. And if you look at team by team, they have quite other resources. They have gone through a lot of more stages than the players have here. Many of the guys here, they said like, maybe I don't want to do everything about my life should be hockey. So we went to school.
But for 2 weeks, the Swedish players lived a different life from normal. They lived to the rhythm of an elite team, and they lived to a very precise schedule, including hours of studying, because the players are, first and foremost, students, called to high academic studies.
Everyone is students, actually. Many study engineering. Last time we were in Trentino, everybody was engineers, and this time is a mix. But most of the players are engineers, students, and we also have economics students and other kind of studies.
In the Universiad, the Swedish team is a special case. Even though Sweden is one of the strongest nations in ice hockey, until 2010, university hockey barely existed. The students had to take matters into their own hands.
We haven't mentioned to create some university hockey league, and that's why I find something missing here. So I took the opportunity to actually create the league. And I think and I hope that the Ice Hockey Association in Sweden will take this as a good start. And, you know, it's very important because this national university team is one very big reason to keep, you know, continue to playing your sport, ice hockey, and to participating in UHL when you start studying in some university in Sweden, because you always want to play for a national team.
It took the creation of the University League by the students themselves to finally return Sweden to the Universiad in 2013 after an absence of 45 years. And still, the players have to make sacrifices.
You know, all the players here are actually paying for themselves, so it's also, it's not just to pick the players who actually are the best one. You have to pick the one who actually can come here and pay for themselves, and mostly by our staff, team staff.
In Sweden, the UHL is a non-profit organization. These are players who organize the games, the sale of the tickets, the search for sponsors, and the functioning of the league. And they came to the university games in Spain without much preparation.
We just had one training before going to Spain, and here we have two and three trainings before the first game against Russia. So that's not so much preparation, but most of the players are coming from UHL, our university league back in Sweden, so they know each other pretty much.
Joakim Thompson is the founder of the Swedish University League, and here in Granada, he was the captain of the team that notched up three wins against Korea, Spain and China, and three defeats against Russia, Canada and the USA. No surprise about those defeats.
It's very fun. It's tough, but it's fun because, you know, many players here are playing in KHL and VHL. So these are very, very good players, and that's, of course, very, very fun and, you know, exciting to try to beat some of those guys.
So no medals for Team Sweden, but they enjoyed their time at the university games, the camaraderie and the learning curve, before returning to their academic work back home with renewed vigor.
This is a very good competition because this is as Olympic Games for students sports. So it's the best you can play if you're a college hockey guy.
And that was Campus Sport.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,